Hi everyone, my name is Lauren. I am going to be a senior in the nursing program here this year at Bellin College. Sorry we couldn't actually have you on campus to give you a tour, but we'd still like to do kind of a virtual one and walk you around and show you what we have to offer. So this is right where you come in. This is our front desk when you first walk in the door. There's usually always somebody here, so either it's a student assistant or a security guard, Scott. So usually it's kind of a first stop. If you need anything, have any questions, you can stop there and ask, and they can kind of get you going in the right direction. This is our admissions office here at Bellin College. So you'll work with admissions most when you first come into the school, but they're always here if you have any questions or need anything. Here we have our atrium. This is kind of where all the students gather and spend a lot of time between classes. A lot of students will come out here and eat lunch when they do have time. I really like the atrium because of, obviously, you can see the huge window, so it lets a lot of light in. And when you're standing inside studying all day, it's nice to be able to see what's going on outside, get some daylight. Otherwise, there's just tables. It's not really the quietest place if you're wanting to study or something like that, but there are options there, so it's just a good place to gather, talk with friends, eat lunch, hang out. This is our student lounge. So one of the big things in here is the mailboxes. Everybody, when they come to campus, is assigned a mailbox. So you'll find in your BC portal online, there is the number for your box and then the combination. So some professors, different clubs will use those to get things back and forth. So it's nice to check it often when you can. There are also a couple of computers in here and the printer, which are nice to have between classes. If you need to print something off quickly, it's good to have that option. Otherwise, there's just some chairs to kind of hang out, the TV. And then right on that side there, there's kind of a closed off room with a whiteboard. So it's a place a lot of students will gather to kind of collaborate and study. And then there's a couple computers in there as well. Here at Bellin College, we don't have necessarily the traditional cafeteria, but we do have a couple options for lunches and snacks and things like that. So we have our BC Express, which always has, there's a daily soup usually, sandwich, lots of different snack options, things like that, coffee, salad bar. So I mean, there is stuff here for you to eat. And then we also do have our vending area, so it's got fridges, microwaves. There is some new like vending machines and food options in there as well for when the BC Express closes at the end of the day. So the options always open if you're here studying late, but otherwise people just kind of pack their cold lunches, toss them in the fridges, and go and grab them when they're ready to eat, which I kind of like the vibe that gives off. You know, just kind of home, you bring your lunch, put it in the fridge and grab it when you're ready. Alright, so here is our one-stop shop at Bellin College. So it really is what it says it is. I mean, in here we've got the registrar, the bursar, financial aid, IT, so really any questions, anything you're needing answered, problems, anything that comes up really, you can come into here and usually get that answer you're looking for. If for some reason they can't help you here, they'll set you in the right direction for where you can get your questions answered. A nice little extra room that we have here at the college is our reflection room. So it's like got the full windows, a couple benches. People will come in here just to get kind of some quiet. It's a good place to catch a break between classes. Some people will, I mean, we've seen people napping in here, people studying, so really kind of all around use, but it's a nice little room off the back with the windows and everything. Okay, these are the academic offices. So you have the office of all of the deans, so the dean of the nursing program, your imaging, general education, all of their offices are in here. They're very approachable people. You might think, oh, the deans, but they're awesome to talk to as well if you have any questions, any problems, things that are coming up with classes or clinicals. Don't be afraid to come in here and ask them for help because they're more than willing to help, which I think is one of the great parts about Bellin College is you really get to know everybody and everybody's willing to help you, wanting to help you succeed and do your best. All right, this is where student services is. So we have our dean of students back here is her office. So they're really kind of oversee all of the clubs at Bellin College, which I think is one of the really big bonuses about the school. It's small enough where you can really get involved in those clubs. My experience here, I've been with the ambassadors, I've worked with Student Senate, I've worked with our Bellin College Student Nurses Association, and I think those are some of my favorite experiences of nursing school, so I really encourage people to look at those opportunities and try and take them, because not only does it look good on a resume, but also those experiences are really helpful going into the profession as well. This is Classroom 113. It's actually our biggest lecture hall on campus. So it's got the nice cushy chairs and all the tables that kind of go up through the back. Like I said, it's our biggest lecture hall, so it does fit quite a few people. Otherwise, throughout the campus, we do have some smaller classrooms as well, but this is gonna be where more of your main, at least in the nursing program, where more of your main nursing classes will kind of take place. So there is the whiteboards up at the front and the screen that comes down. So that's where the professor typically is, but it's easy, always easy to just raise your hand, ask questions during class, which I think is another great part about Bellin College is the professors are more than willing to answer questions. They're accessible. And I mean, for a lecture, being our biggest lecture hall, it's not huge. So you still can't hide away. When you walk down the main stairs, this is kind of the first spot you hit when you come into the lower level labs. So it's just kind of a place to sit. There's the computer and the printer, which is nice to have right down here in case you did need to print something during class. Otherwise, students will just kind of gather, take a break out here between labs and things like that. We do have our science lab right on campus as well. So this is utilized for the general education classes. So your biology, microbiology, and anatomy and physiology. So there's the microscopes, all the anatomy models, everything that you really need for those classes are in here, and that's where the labs for those take place.
Are you ready?
This is one of our two main health assessment labs. So this is, health assessment is one of the first main nursing courses that you'll take. It's really kind of the basis for everything that you'll do. So you start in here, you've got a partner for those classes, you kind of go through from head to toe, going through that assessment and the different parts of it, and then at the end you'll test off. So there's all the beds, all the exam materials and everything.
Are you ready?
So we have several simulation labs on campus for different courses. You will have simulations. So you kind of get together as a group before you talk about the patients that you'll have, and then you go in and take care of them, go through the situation that's going on, and then you debrief afterwards. So this is one of those labs. Actually, there looks like they're doing a test off right now. So we can't actually go in, but there are mannequins in there. So it's a really good, they can talk, you can give them fluids, all that kind of thing. Pretty much anything that you and I can do, they can do as well. So it's a really good environment to learn. And if you, by chance, do make those mistakes, you definitely remember them and won't make them again. This is one of our unique simulation labs on campus. This is our maternity suite. So Victoria here actually goes through the whole birthing process. You can kind of follow her through it as her cervix dilates, all of that, and then she will give birth to our baby mannequin Tori at the end of it, so you can kind of do care for both mom and baby. So really cool opportunity to kind of see that whole process before actually going out into the clinical environment. So this is our ER here on campus. It's set up like a normal emergency room, and we have our mannequin Mike here. He does pretty much everything that you and I can do. He blinks, talks, he cries, he bleeds, you can give him fluids, you can give him medications, check for pulses, check for lung sounds, heart sounds, pretty much everything. So really cool opportunity to learn and go through some of those scenarios that can happen before you actually go out and experience them. And this is our surgery suite here. So we do have our mannequin ready for surgery. I believe he's got some bullet wounds in him. So in the nursing program, you'll kind of utilize this room to learn the sterile technique. So outside we do have all this stuff for scrubbing into surgery. So washing your hands, gowning up, putting on the caps, everything like that. And then I know your radiology students will use the surgery suite to practice doing imaging during procedures as well.
Hello everyone, my name is Mark Bake. I'm the Dean of Allied Health Sciences and the Program Director for the Radiologic Sciences Program here at Bellin College. We are in the Health Science Resource Center and I wanted to give you a tour of the medical imaging equipment. So come right this way. So for our radiology program, we have two radiology labs. This first lab is fully functional. It is the latest and greatest technology. It is a digital radiography room, meaning we use this imagery receptor here. Everything is wireless, and when you place a body part over it and make an exposure, it pops up on a computer screen in the back within a couple seconds. So pretty amazing technology. This is one of our two radiology rooms. For our students, during their sophomore year, they actually spend about 7 hours a week down in this radiology lab learning and perfecting their skill. So it's a method and a way for us to ensure that our students feel extremely comfortable here in a safe learning environment, and they're then ready to hit the ground running when they start in clinical. So we have all the equipment here on campus. Because we use radiation, we are not allowed to x-ray each other, so we have various phantoms that we can x-ray. Each one has a name just to be fun. This is Julius. You can see Julius. He's actually transparent and you can see through him. But when we actually take images, it looks exactly the same as what you'd see with a real patient. In addition to our mannequins, we have images that we can pull up of every body part. We have over 200 bones in our body. So throughout this program, you learn how to image each and every body parts, and we have a lot of example images that we can pull up here. So this is an example of a chest x-ray that you see on the screen. We can see the ribs kind of outlined here. Here's the clavicle, here's the heart border here, and then here's your diaphragm. So that's kind of the neat part about the medical imaging program as well. You learn all the anatomy and then understand normal versus abnormal and how it should look on an x-ray. This next room is our control area. So while you're in the program, we learn how to take x-rays and again, how really to understand how much x-ray we need for each body part. So if we're x-raying a hand, it's much different than x-raying someone's abdomen, because a hand is less space and less area to penetrate. So over on our right side, you can kind of see when we click on different things, we pull up different parameters and different techniques to then expose our patients. And then on the left, this is the screen that I mentioned, it's all digital now, so when you make that exposure, that image pops up on the screen within about 2 seconds. So this is an example of looking at a digital image. In the past, when I went to school, we went to a dark room and developed our films and hung them up on a view box, such as you see here. So this view box, you know, we have our film, and if I wanted to zoom in on an image, I would have to pull out a magnifying glass and look at that image. So times have changed quite drastically now, and now we have these digital images. So to kind of show you how this works, if I was maybe worried about something in the hand here, I can just click a button and I can zoom in and look at that particular body part with just the capabilities of the computer. So it's like taking an old Polaroid picture or taking a picture with a digital camera, where now I can zoom in, we can change the appearance. So if I want to try to look at the soft tissue a little bit more, we can window and level things a little bit differently. So the power of the computer definitely changed our profession a little bit and definitely kind of put more of that technology spin on it. So our control room here controls both of our radiology labs. Every student and every faculty also wear one of these badges, and this monitors how much radiation our students and our faculty receive in clinical. So every 3 months, this little piece gets sent away, and then I get a report back, and it documents how much radiation our students get. Typically, it's very, very minimum, but we do track that to be on the safe side. This is our second radiology lab. You can see another one of our mannequins. Again, they all have names. That is Wounded Willie, so he actually has different pathologies. So a lot of times in radiology, you take more than one image. So for an example, on William over there, if we're x-raying his pelvis, we might take one image without moving him at all, and see that he has a fractured pelvis. So now we can't move his leg at all for our next image, so we are gonna move our equipment. So a lot of critical thinking involved in having these mannequins is very, very helpful. We also have a portable x-ray machine as well. So when patients are too sick or too ill to come to us in like an ER situation or maybe an ICU situation, we can bring x-ray to them. So we utilize a portable machine for training, but also for some interprofessional education where we might do a trauma with nursing students. And you know, we prioritize. This patient needs an x-ray, they need labs drawn, they need all these different things. So let's work together as a team and figure out what needs to be done next. Over here, this is our anatomage table. We utilize this quite a bit in the medical imaging program. And really the anatomage table is a virtual cadaver. So we have two male and two female cadavers on this anatomage table. Everything's touch screen, so it's like a giant iPad. So you can turn them from side to side. I'm just gonna turn them sideways. Grab a scalpel and make an incision here. And then just with a click of a finger, I'm gonna roll them back and we can actually see now the internal aspects of our cadaver. And kind of the neat part about this compared to a cadaver lab is there's different features. So I can turn something on here and now anywhere I click, it will tell me the muscle, the bone, the organ. So great from a teaching perspective. Another thing is if you know a student's really struggling, maybe they're having a hard time learning the nerves, because the nerves can be really tricky in the human body. We can turn different systems on and off. So I'm gonna turn everything off and just turn the nervous system on. And it looks a little funny, but we can see here's the entire nervous system of this patient. And again, I can turn this feature on, and now any nerve that I click, it will highlight it and tell me what nerve it is. So again, from a learning perspective, it's just an amazing tool. One of the courses I teach in particular, cross-sectional anatomy, so looking at the body in slices. So this machine is just invaluable from that perspective. In addition to the cadavers, we also have 180 abnormal CT and MRI scans on here. So I'll just show you one. This is a CT scan of the brain. And now in CT, we can actually get these 3D renditions. So this is a real patient. This is a CT scan. And I can, again, grab my scalpel and just make an incision. Then I'll tip it down for you. Try to straighten them out a little bit here. Right now it looks like an empty skull, right? So I'm gonna add some more of the anatomy in by windowing and leveling. And these are the arteries in the brain. We can kind of see these finger-like projections. So the arteries are giving that oxygen-rich, that nutrient blood to the brain, very, very important. What we can kind of see right here, this large, almost like a balloon. So this would be considered an aneurysm. So now we can show students, you know, this is what a CT scan would look like, and this is what an abnormal CT scan would look like. So this is looking at it 3D, but I can also pull up what it would look like on a conventional or traditional CT scan. So let me turn it around, make it a little larger here. So now again, we're looking at the skull and we're kind of cutting up and down. So you can kind of see how it works. And here is that large aneurysm here as well. And again, I can look top to down. We can look front to back, we can kind of scroll through, or we can look side to side. So again, this is an amazing, amazing tool. We utilize it quite a bit in all of our medical imaging programs. Just to kind of show you really quickly, here's our case library. So we have head, chest, abdomen. But if I just click on the chest here, all the abnormal chest CTs and MRIs. So very, very cool to not only explain how some of these imaging exams work, but then actually show what some abnormalities look like. So in the radiology program, again, the lab is utilized quite a bit, especially in the sophomore year. We actually split our students up and we only have about 4 or 5 students per lab session in here. So we only have two or three students per lab session in the radiology lab. So something that makes our radiology program very unique is the specialty training that our students receive as well. So this room next door here, this is our mammography lab. So our students have the ability to choose 2 of the 3 specialties. So we offer CT, MRI, and mammography. And similar to the radiology lab, our mammography lab is completely digital. Everything works. So for imaging the breast tissue, we have special equipment. A mammogram is a very common exam to have in radiology. So again, here our students can learn how to operate the equipment in a safe learning environment, so then when they go to clinical for mammography, they feel completely safe with the equipment, and they can concentrate more on patient care. So this classroom is specific for radiologic sciences. You can kind of see in the back, we have two images, and the one on the right is an MRI machine, and then the one on the left is our CT machine. So these are simulators, and we'll walk back there and I'll show you the computers. What makes them very unique is the software is exactly what you would see at a hospital or at a clinic. So we can teach you how to operate a CT machine here on campus. So again, when you get to clinical, you feel very comfortable. So we'll come back and I'll show you what one looks like. I have a CT simulator booted up. And CT, it's very, very quick exam now. It takes about a minute to get a patient in and out of the CT suite. But there's a lot going on from the computer perspective. So you can see, we can set everything up. In CT, we have things called protocols. So I'm just gonna pull a protocol up here. And we can actually simulate going through this entire exam. And we can see we have images and we can change the parameters. So again, very, very nice from a teaching perspective. On the right screen here, up on the projector, I have an example again of what a CT might look like. So this is a CT of the hip. And again, we can put all of our images together. So think of CT as a loaf of bread and taking slices. We can put all those slices back together and make the loaf again, right? So we can put all these slices together and make this 3D rendition of this patient's hip. And make it a little bit larger here for you. So here we can kind of see a little circle with my mouse. This whole area, this is the fracture, this is the femur, or the lower leg, and we can kind of see all these fragments. So many times, you know, radiology is the first step. A patient might get an x-ray and they might see a fracture, but they want the surgeon, the doctors might want more detail than there were a CT such as this. So again, having this equipment on campus is just amazing. It's really, really enhances the student's education because they can see and understand how everything works, and we can take our time and explain it, because once you get to the clinical sites and there's patients involved, it can be a very, very busy and sometimes stressful situation. So learning it here definitely helps our students feel more comfortable. So this is our sonography lab. What makes our sonography program extremely unique is it's a 3-year program, and our students learn general, OB, and vascular scanning. You can see in our lab here, we have 4 stations with 4 sonography units. All of them are newer and state of the art. We also have a portable ultrasound unit off to the side here, which is a mind ray, which can be used much more frequently in emergency settings or provider offices. You'll also notice in this room we have these chairs that look a little funny. So one thing that we've been spending a lot of time with our students on is ergonomics. Sonography, a statistic is about 70% of sonographers scan in pain on a daily basis because they're constantly using your arm. So a lot of rotator cuff injuries and elbow injuries. So prior to our students picking up a probe, they have an entire course dedicated to ergonomics and learning proper stretching, so we can help create a long tenure for sonographers. We can see off to the side here, this is Christian. He is scanning right now. We do have a number of phantoms, so this is an OB phantom. So we can see on the screen, and then also we can project that on our big screen here. But because sonography does not use radiation, our students can scan each other. So we typically take anywhere from 8 to 10 students, and they're either scanning each other or being scanned through lab. They certainly spend a large amount of their sophomore year in here, again, kind of perfecting their skills prior to starting in clinical. Something that's relatively new for our sonography program as well is our echocardiogram program, which is a 2-semester program where you can earn your echo certificate, which is scanning the hearts. Our newest program for medical imaging is a bachelor's degree in radiation therapy. We'll soon be receiving a virtual reality simulator. The piece of equipment that's utilized for treating cancer is called a linear accelerator. And this virtual linear accelerator will allow students to put on 3D goggles and treat patients in a 3D setting. So it'll be very unique. There's only a few schools in the United States that has this piece of equipment. And it will be a 3-year option, and we are excited to start our first cohort this August. So more to come very soon.
is our library on campus here at Bellin College, so really great place to study, use the resources here. So there are computers as well as a printer for anything that you want to work on, print off. There are all the textbooks for each of the classes up here in the library, which I think is a great resource. You can typically use them just in here. They can't be taken out of the library, but just know that they are up here for an option. Otherwise, there's a large collection of books, resources, and we do also have access to online resources as well. So the librarian, Cindy, is always more than willing to help you kind of find what you're looking for as far as research or things like that. Just know those options are there, and if you need help finding them, she's more than willing to. Otherwise, there are student assistants here at night as well that can help you kind of find what you're looking for. So in the library, you do have the option for the study rooms at the back. So this is one of them. There's a table in here. There's a whiteboard. A lot of students will come back. Kind of the good rooms to either kind of quietly study by yourself or come as a group and collaborate with homework or projects, things like that. You typically, they're most of the time open, but any of the testing that doesn't happen during class will happen up here in the library. So just double check with the librarian, make sure the room is open, there's no testing going on, and you're more than welcome to use them. A very helpful resource on campus is our Student Success Center. So in here, there's a bunch of desks, whiteboards, computers. A lot of students will study in here. It is a little bit quieter, collaborate with different things for classes. Otherwise, it's also kind of your main source for help with classes, help with building resumes, anything like that. There's staff in here all throughout the day, so she's able to help you with, like I said, resumes, going through papers if you need help, kind of going through the grammar, things like that. And then also what you can do with the Student Success Center is they offer tutors. So they take students that have done well in classes and they set them up as tutors. You can go online, sign up, and then this is kind of where you meet for those tutoring sessions. I really encourage you, if you're struggling in a class, or even if you're not really struggling but just feel like you could use a little extra help, a little kind of getting ready for a test, don't be afraid to utilize those tutors, because as I said, they've gone through the class, they kind of know what the professors are looking for, and maybe different things that they say or ways of studying that they use can help you learn as well. So the tutors are a great resource to have, as well as everything else that the Student Success Center offers. A really great option that we do have on campus is our gym. So it's got some of the cardio machines, there's some weights, all the exercise balls, mats, things like that. So it's a really great option to have right here. A lot of students will utilize it after class, between classes, before class. It's just really convenient, and I think working out is a great way to kind of get out some of that stress of nursing school. So if that's something you do, it's great to have it right here on campus. Another aspect of the second floor is all of the faculty offices. So the doors are usually at the end of the hall, they're usually open until 4:00. So the professors are very accessible to you here at Bellin College. All their offices are right together. If you ever have any questions, any concerns, whether it be about class, clinical, I mean, applying for jobs, anything, don't be afraid to come up here and find them in their office, because they're always more than willing to help you figure it out what it is you need to be successful. Also on the second floor, we do have the development office and then the president's office. So development, really, they're just friendly bunch, so stop in and say hi. Otherwise, they deal with scholarships. They are also in charge of ambassadors. So as ambassadors, we go out and kind of work with high school students in the area, recruitment, things like that. So stop by and say hi. Otherwise, also feel free to stop in Connie's office as well. She's very friendly, always open to help too. That concludes our tour of Bellin College. Thank you guys for sticking with us and going through it. We're happy to still be able to show you around. If you do have any further questions though, please feel free to reach out to admissions, and hopefully we can see you on campus very soon.